today, I'm very happy to update my data science certifications ranked tier list. Now, essentially what that means is I'll be filling out this following picture, where a course is either essential, I really, really strongly push it, very good, like, you know, it's very good, but maybe not quite as required as essential, and then avoid with the almost puke emoji. I think that makes it pretty clear, then I don't recommend it at all. So I'm not going to show you all the courses that I have here, but everything is from Coursera. So I'm going to start with the IBM Data Analyst and put that in very good. If you are going to be a data scientist, you know, you do need to learn analytics, which is like, you know, Excel, SQL, all the basic tabular data stuff. But what this doesn't do is give any sort of headway into predictive models and that type of thing. It's more traditional analytics. And so if you're trying to be an analyst, then this is the way to go. But we'll see that the IBM Data Science is just better and better aimed at data science and machine learning folk. Okay, I will grab the deep learning specialization. Of course, if you know me at all, I will put this at essential immediately. It's by Andrew Ng, you know, my favorite teacher in the world. He teaches it super well, all about neural networks and their various designs from the ground up of what a neural network is, all the way up until training the, you know, pretty much the most complex ones that we have. And they update this all the time with new advancements like transformers they did not too long ago. So yeah, staple, definitely learn that if you can. The Johns Hopkins Data Science, it's so it's in R. I think that Python is more versatile. You can do more clever tricks with it to work faster in a much broader range of environments. And so I would prefer Python. But if you're looking to learn R, extremely good. The University of Washington Machine Learning. So this is in Python. It's actually very good. It does a good job of teaching the traditional, like important supervised learning stuff, like what is regression, classification, all the way up until, you know, more complicated machine learning models. It's great, and it is in Python, which I love. But I also am not putting it in essential. It has to go in very good because something else reserves that slot for essential, but this is a great option. I really strongly think that. The Mathematics for Machine Learning by Imperial College London. Now, this is not a machine learning course. This is mathematics so that you can learn machine learning, which is very important. I'm going to put that at very good. Now, it's almost essential, as in knowing that math, I'd pretty much consider essential, but the course itself is not super, super phenomenal enough for me to put it in essential, but it, you know, it's very good, actually. The Machine Learning Engineering for Production ML Ops. ML Ops, I'd have to say that, I'd have to put that at very good, because it's, you know, it's just very good. It's a great set of courses, and, you know, deeplearning.ai is awesome. But the whole idea about learning all of these different MLOps things, I don't find it to be super, super necessary. But, you know, if you're trying to expand your horizons and learn more and more, which is great, you know, it's a very good course, but I would not put it as essential. Sorry, I'm going to zoom out a bit because it's getting a little clouded. Google Data Analytics. Okay, this is one of the main reasons that I am updating my tier list, is because I would put this... I feel like before I would have put it in some kind of medium between very good and avoid, but I'm definitely putting it in very good, and it's very close to essential. Now, I underrated this the first time, but it's awesome, okay? Because for any data scientist or machine learning, you have to learn the traditional analytics stuff. And given that that's true, so like SQL, you know, data visualization and all of the tabular data stuff, Google Data Analytics, having that certification on your you know, LinkedIn profile or whatever is very, very helpful just because it's Google. And the courses themselves are great. They're really, really good. You learn, you know, a bunch of useful stuff. And so that belongs in very good in my eyes, very close to essential. We have the IBM Applied AI, which I'm almost putting it at avoid. It's kind of an in-between a very good and avoid. And maybe I'll decide later if that goes to avoid. For now, it's overrated is really the word that I would apply for that, because it's okay, but it's not super phenomenal. You don't go that much in depth on learning AI, and it's kind of like you're saying that you know AI, but in my opinion, you don't. You would learn a lot more through machine learning, deep learning, and honestly, even data science, in my opinion. Yeah, I mean, I can't put that in the same category as Google Data Analytics, so I'm going to put that in avoid, honestly. IBM Machine Learning is good because it's often compared to that. I mean, you can see they look very similar, but that goes in very good. And actually, it almost goes in essential because they teach some really good things here. But if you look it up, it doesn't have that many ratings. Like it's not, not that many people have taken it. And I think that might be because, you know, IBM has so many of these courses on Coursera, and some of them are extremely popular, some of them are less popular, but this is really good. It teaches some phenomenal things quite well, and I would recommend that definitely over the Applied AI. Business analytics is something that, you know, very good depending on who you are. Many of you are trying to be or already are in a more traditional business kind of Excel environment. And depending on who you are, Business Analytics by UPenn is a great choice. People loved it. It has very good ratings. But for the more traditional data science analytics, it's not super necessary in my opinion. Deep Learning.ai TensorFlow Developer. Now, essentially what this is you'd probably take this around the same time or probably just after the deep learning specialization, because you most certainly do use TensorFlow in this specialization to implement the algorithms and to use them. But this goes a little bit further into some TensorFlow specifics. And do I consider it as essential? Not really. It's very, very good. And it's above maybe probably many of these. But I can't put it as essential quite yet. So I'll leave that. Reinforcement learning is very good. To my mind, that immediately jumps into very good because, you know, you'll learn about reinforcement learning from pretty much the ground up. It is a little bit mathy. And so I might recommend some of the mathy stuff before that. But, you know, if you're interested in the topic, it's very good. And if you, you know, if you are someone that is super really wanting to learn reinforcement learning, then, you know, I would put it as essential. But most people probably aren't. So it stands at very good in my eyes. AI for everyone. I'm not going to put it as avoid, although I sort of almost think that because, you know, it's not worthy of a puke emoji. But it's good. It's okay. And it's probably the bottom of this very good because it's just general. It's very basic. And I don't think you'll learn a whole lot about the world by doing that. But, you know, it's good. And for very, very beginner, like almost kind of high school level, and someone that just doesn't know about AI in the slightest, probably a good idea to just kind of watch that through. Learn SQL Basics by University of California is awesome. It's very good. If you know, I'm going to put it as essential, honestly, because, you know, many people, you know, it's hard to follow some strict pathway all the time, although I do have a pathway. If you just want to, you know, learn SQL in specifically that, then, you know, I'm going to put that as essential because you need to learn SQL. I may move that because of something else I'll put there, but, you know, SQL by itself right now is actually essential. Data visualization with Tableau, that I feel like you probably know what I'm going to put there. It stands very firmly at very good. And I have to zoom out a little bit more, unfortunately. Hopefully you can still see it. Yeah, data visualization with Tableau. You know, if you want to learn Tableau, it'll be great for that. And it's a useful tool, but I wouldn't consider it essential by any means. Introduction to statistics and advanced statistics, I will deal with. Actually, all three of these I'll deal with at the same time and zoom back in. So Introduction to Statistics by Stanford, Advanced Statistics by John Hopkins. They also have statistics and Statistics with Python by University of Machine Learning. They all stand firmly at very good. And I wanted to do that at the same time because there's a lot of different statistics courses. You know, just be careful if, you know, you're trying to aim for a particular programming language. It's pretty clear that Statistics with Python is by UMichigan. Advanced Statistics is, you know, the John Hopkins stuff uses R. And so I would, you know, if you like R, then I would do that. And anything Stanford is usually a little bit more difficult and sometimes rigorous. So be careful. But this course is it's pretty good, actually. A few left. We have the Hands-On Foundations for Data Science and Machine Learning with Google Cloud Labs. Now, there are many of these Google Cloud data science and machine learning things. And so I'm not going to talk about all of them there. That would be quite the video. But essentially, you need one of them. You need something. And I will put, you know, this one at essential. It's the only one I have in this list here. It's very good. Basically, you need something where you go on the cloud and you do this stuff, well, on the cloud. And, you know, for anyone that is essential, you would do it after pretty much all the other stuff, most likely. You could do it in the middle, but most likely you would learn all of the data science and machine learning fundamentals, and then you would kind of implement that on the cloud, and then you're good to go. Algebra, elementary to advanced. I threw this in here as a, you know, just a basic math course. You know, it stands firmly at very good. I don't really want to cloud that up anymore because it's getting a little bit small. So I'm actually just not even going to rate that. But if you're looking to learn math, John Hopkins gives an algebra course, and it's very useful for that. Okay, IBM Data Science is, you know, if you know me, I will put that right there. It's where I would start. It's essential if you're trying to be a data scientist and do machine learning stuff. Basically, you know, it's all of the IBM data analyst, but this is in Python. It's an excellent set of courses, and the certification itself does hold value. Stanford Machine Learning. So this stands for both the one that he's about to update. As is, it's June 1st for me. And so anytime now, Andrew Ng is going to launch the updated machine learning course, but either way, the link in the description and what I'm about to say applies to both. It's going to be amazing, the new one, and the old one was, you know, fantastic. He's making the new one in Python, so I 100% guarantee you that even though I haven't seen the course yet, I will definitely vouch for that beforehand. It teaches all about machine learning fundamentals, the statistics behind that, and it does the math like before, so that it lines up so that you aren't really missing anything and you can take it from almost scratch. Some basic math would be useful, but you know, just amazing course, absolute staple for data science and machine learning. There's, you know, no better place to be. TensorFlow Advanced. So basically this is what you would take after the, after deep learning and after, where did I put it? After the deep learning.ai TensorFlow developer and deep learning, if you want to keep learning about TensorFlow, then you would do the TensorFlow advanced techniques. And I think it stands very firmly at very good. It's not really essential, but it's very solid. Practical data science on the AWS cloud. So I will put this as essential, but what I mean by this is essential, AWS or the Google Cloud. If you want to do both, by all means, that's great. But you don't need both the Google Cloud and the AWS data science. The purpose is to go on the cloud and start implementing this stuff and doing it in practice on their systems. It doesn't really matter which one you choose, but you know, either or both is great. And again, you know, algebra, I'm just going to leave. Well, I mean, I made that thicker anyway, so might as well put it in very good. Okay, so I am going to just talk about each of these things very quickly. So in order here to list it, basically you need to do the IBM data science. So how do I do this? This is getting complicated. There we go. IBM data science. And then after that, you can go ahead and take the machine learning course, either the new one or the old one, whatever's available, the deep learning specialization, and then get on the cloud. Sorry, SQL should also be not really in there anymore. It's not necessary. It's a great course, but basically here's the order of things. Data science, machine learning, deep learning, and that stuff on the cloud. And then anything in here in the very good is an excellent option. And you know, you're going to learn a lot. It depends what you want to do. You can see this is a little bit Python biased, as in the stuff in R I do have in very good. Of course, if you vastly prefer R, then you could basically change most of these from the IBM or the John Hopkins, those versions into the Python versions of what I have listed here. And then, you know, you're an R programmer and then you're good to go. It's the same kind of stuff, but I prefer the Python pathway. All right, I hope that was helpful. Everything is in the description down below. If you could drop a like on the video and help me out, you know, I'd greatly appreciate it. But of course, you don't have to. And, you know, have a great day. I seriously hope that you do. Okay, bye, guys.